Hey friend, Alan Lee here with Honestly Handyman Services, and today I wanted to talk a little bit about trailer maintenance and updating. So I'm going to take you inside my trailer today and show you a little bit about what I've been doing and how I keep it maintained. Alright, here's my trailer. As you can see, I got my sawhorses and bench out there. Usually my sawhorses stay in this cubby here, and my bench, which is at 3x5, 3/4 inch plywood, stays here. And in maintaining and improving your trailer is so important. I wanted to show you guys a little bit about what I've been up to. This stuff here, is, if you have followed me before, is pretty much all standard. These are all my drawers. One big thing that I'm gonna do today is go through all these drawers. These drawers have been full for about 3 years, and there's probably, I would say, 60% of this stuff I do not use. And you know, the other 40% I do, but I need to get rid of that 60% of stuff that I do not use and replace it with, you know, make it so it is only housing what I use on a daily basis. So this is something new that I've added here. This is for my my batteries here. This is just Ryobi batteries would go here, and Milwaukee batteries would go here, and then dead batteries would go up there. Obviously, this is still kind of a, you know, a work in progress here. This isn't really the side I've been working on today, but I'm going to be working on this later today. I've been working on the other side today. And these are all my cubbies here for all of my tools. This would be my Milwaukee impact drivers, drills, things like that, hacksaw. And then these are empty. Obviously, I have them out. This is where my sander would go and things like that. Here's another new guy that I got. And then I keep this. This is my mixing pan all the time. Got my leaf blower. I used to keep my air compressor here, but I just got a Ryobi 18 volt brad nailer, so I don't need to keep my compressor here anymore. So I have this that I'm going to be adding something to. Got my miter saw, my table saw, and then getting back here, this is getting into what new that we have built. Just this morning I built these. Not the prettiest thing in the world, but it works. So this is for my caulking tubes. This can hold three in a row going back, and then these ones back here are big enough for spray paints as well as drywall textures, which I'm really happy about. I was building these this morning, and then my wife was telling me that, oh, I should make some more for my spray paints and drywall texture, and that's fabulous idea. And then right below I got some extra 20-minute mud, and then my screws here. I usually have 3-inch screws that go right here. Those are out right now. And then this is another thing that I added just this morning. This is for all of my shop rags. My wife and I would call them my Sir Wally's. Kind of a weird, funny story. We got all these from the thrift store. And on the bottom of one of them, it said Sir Wally. So we call them all my Sir Wally's. And then with that, I created this, kind of just fits in here, that it holds three different rolls of paper towels. You know, one in the front and then two in the back, and then also some illustrious toilet paper back there. You always got to have that just in case. And then getting back to, this is where all my used Sir Wally's would go, and then where those would go. And then this down here is all my long stuff. So right in front are my knee pads, and then shovels and a hoe, and you know, all kinds of things down there. And then my long level, short level goes here. These are my fishing rods. Shorter level goes here. And then in the back here, we have access to, you know, our pile driver and things like that. And then in the middle here, we have these three drawers. This is for plumbing. Plumbing drawer. Obviously, just like all these other drawers, I would say probably 60% of this stuff I do not use. It's kind of just been compiled in here. So today, I've been working on that side this morning. So later this afternoon, I'm going to be getting rid of this stuff and cleaning it all out, going through it, maintaining it. Here's my electrical. And again, maintenance is so important on a trailer, because there's nothing worse than having this. This is just, this is horrible here. What's going on in this area? And maintaining your trailer is one of the most important things, because there's nothing worse than having a trailer that you can't get into. You know, you need to be able to access your trailer and get into it, because at the end of the day, the whole point of a trailer is so that everything is organized, that you can know exactly where something is when you need it. That's the whole thought of having these as well as these, because before, rags were just everywhere in this area, and caulking tubes we're everywhere in this area as well. This is kind of just a catch-all area here. So that's one of the most important things, is in maintaining your trailer so that you know exactly where everything is and always improving it. One of the biggest things is that most people, they are frustrated with how their trailer is. I know for me, I was for a long time, but they don't take the time to repair it and make it the way that it's supposed to be or the way that they want it to be. So adding this simple thing here, this is huge. And then that guy there is just so huge to the lifeblood of what my trailer is and what it's supposed to be. But it's all about taking the time out of your schedule to do this work. And really, this is work that will pay off in dividends, because this will make you faster, will make you quicker, will be able to make you more money and have more sanity at the end of the day. So it's very important to, you know, take care of your tool trailer, maintain it, clean it out, sweep it out every once in a while. It's one of the, you know, the things that you do not think about when you have a trailer, believe me. So I got a lot of work to do. I'm gonna be cleaning out this side and organizing that this afternoon. So thank you all so much for tuning into this video. Please like this video, leave me a comment in the comment section below, and subscribe to this channel. We'll see you all in the next video. Have a great day.